Hi, it's Paul Gardner.
Paul, it's Roger Barker here. How are you?
Hello. Yeah, fine, thank you.
I haven't interrupted you, have I?
No, not at all.
You're not having afternoon tea or anything?
It's about time for it, isn't it?
It is, absolutely. I've just had a couple of scones. Delicious. I believe my assistant, she came down and she had a word with you regarding one of the phantoms.
That's right.
What can you offer me today, now?
Today, now?
I'm feeling frivolous.
We have got a four-seat Arnage.
Right.
Which has just arrived in the showroom. It's the highest specification Arnage we've built.
What colour is it?
It's dark blue with a cream interior.
Well, that's lucky, isn't it?
It's lucky because you like that colour.
It's lucky because my wife likes that colour, yes.
Right. When would you like to pop down and see it?
Well, I don't know. I think I might just put down a deposit now.
Yes?
Well, if that's all right with you, Paul.
That would be perfect.
What are we looking at?
As a deposit?
Yeah?
We need £10,000 on any car.
Okay. Have you got a pen?
I'm holding a pen in my hand.
My wallet is... Hold on. I'll just put you on hold for a second. Don't move.
Okay.
Paul, are you there?
I'm here.
Wonderful. Yeah. Should I just give you digits?
Okay.
Yep. It's 5, 4, 6, 0.
Hang on, I missed it.
4, 6, 4. And the valid from...
Hang on, I think I'm...
6, 0, 8. And you spell it R-O-G-E-M-K.
Hang on, I'm missing your...
Okay, and... did you want that security number on the back?
Yes, please.
It's 4-8.
Right, I...
Could you just read that back to me? Because I've had so much trouble with this card. People
are
consistently...
I've lost completely.
Sorry, could you say that again? You're breaking up.
Yeah, it was breaking up. And I lost the card number.
Sorry?
You broke up as you were reading out the number to me, so I didn't get...
You caught me saying...
I got 5-4.
So I could... 4, yes.
And that's all I got.
7-3.
7-3.
6-2. So, 7.
No, I missed it.
1, 4, 6.
You mean I missed that number?
Sorry?
The number kept missing.
Which number?
Your card number.
I've just given you the number twice.
I know, but shall I ring you back?
Fucking... Hello?
I look down, and she's got a pair of balls. Fuck off. Pair of balls.
You sell the pink puss bear?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello, can
I help? Oh, good. I was interested in purchasing a property.
Yes, you need to see our sales department. There's no one there at the moment. They're out on viewings. Can I get someone to give you a call?
Oh, great. Are you on rentals, are you?
Yes.
Oh, well, I wouldn't mind renting before I buy, actually. Maybe that will be a better idea.
Okay, what sort of thing are you after?
Well, I don't know. Something maybe, 2-bedroom. It's me and the wife. And then we'd have the kids come in. See, just wait one moment, sorry.
The next train to arrive on platform 3 is your 1634 service, calling to all stations, including Heathrow Airport and Hayes and Harlington. Thank you.
Sorry, love, I'm just at work at the moment.
That's fine.
Where was I? Sorry.
Yeah, what sort of thing...
A semi-detached, was it?
What sort of budget do you have per week?
Oh, the budget. 300? Is that a bit low? Should I go up a bit?
Yeah, you probably need to go...
350.
The best thing I can say is, do you have access to the internet?
Internet? Oh, I do, yes.
Yeah, do you want to
look on
our website?
Not at the moment, though. Sorry, one moment.
Delays are currently occurring on the Bakerloo line, Piccadilly line, and Northern line. Thank you.
Hello?
Hello.
Sorry about that.
That's fine.
Very difficult doing two things at once, you know. Can we just get to the biscuit? Can I rent a house from you or not?
Yes, but the best thing to do is to look on our website.
But I'm at work at the moment, dear, which is why I've snuck away to call you.
Right.
Could you give me some advice? Can you find me a house for £350 a week, 2-bedroom? Don't mind if it's got a pond. If it does, will you clean it for me?
Sorry. We have properties, okay, and they're on. I mean, we get 2 beds on.
Customers are reminded that this is a no-smoking station. I repeat, a no-smoking station.
Hello?
Test it. It's about my wife's bush. But sir, I am totally legitimate. Jude Law's testicles.
Good afternoon, customer service.
Hello?
Hello,
yes. There was a particular song that I wanted to buy.
Yes?
But I didn't know the name of it. I only know the tune.
I don't think that I really can help you.
But perhaps if I sing you the tune, maybe you know which song I'm talking about.
Oh, yes, do please sing the tune.
Prop top ship da ba di bi do. Rip di shi di ba sten ba. Di rap top ship da ba di di do. Rip di sha di ba sten ba. Rip di sha da 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 da. Rip, dip, show, ba da da da. Hello? Hello?
No, hello. No, I cannot recognize the song. But perhaps if you phone.
You don't know the name of the tune?
No, but I think.
Maybe I'll sing you a little bit more. Maybe it jog your memory.
I don't think so.
Rip shop, dibidibido, shum dibidab, shibidido, a bimsema, rubab delu. Dibidib ship dib rabadab shabber in a restaurant. It was in town, dub the ship dib ramdabis sound. On the ground, it was in town, dub the ship dub a biddibel. It up the shout of beautiful. Brim dip shit of it, please. Vidarib dip shout in a damn well. A rib dip shout of his thin dough. Brim dip shout. Do. Brim. Dib, she, bibble.
No, I think you actually need to phone another shop.
Really?
I think so.
Oh, dear.
It doesn't sound classical at all, I have to say.
Oh, no, it's a classic.
Probably it is a classic, but it's not classical.
Well, what kind of classical tune are you talking about?
Hold on. Kind of classical.
Oh, doesn't sound like a classic to me.
Hello.
Good evening, madam. My name is George, and basically, I am ringing to inform you that you have been selected to receive a CPM.
A what?
A cash prize monies. So basically, all I require from you to claim your prize are a few details.
Well, it depends what the details are.
Well, they are nothing too personal. Simply your bank account details and sort code.
No way. Not interested, love.
But
thank you.
It is a lot of monies.
I look down and she's got a pair of balls. Pack off. Pair of balls.
You sell the pink puss bear?
Hello?
Hello?
Oh, hello.
Good day, sir. My name is George. I'm calling from British Gas.
British Gas?
Yes. It seems that we have overcharged you a substantial amount of monies, and we want to pay you the monies back. But in order for us to do this, we need to obtain your bank account details so that we can pay the money directly into your bank account.
You're joking. You think I'm going to fall for that trick?
No, sir.
You want to take my bank account details? I suppose you want a credit card number as well, do you?
Well, if you have one to give us, sir, that would be even better.
You're phoning me on a private number that nobody's got except me and well, a few people, not you.
Well, sir, if you're having an affair, sir, that is between you and your mistress.
You're talking a load of old bollocks. Do you know that?
No, I'm trying to obtain your bank account details, sir.
Do you think I'm going to give you your bank my details? What's my name, then?
But you should know your name, sir.
You fucking idiot. Of course I know my name. I'm asking you to confirm who I am. You don't know.
No, I do know your name, sir, but if
what
you...
What is my name, then?
You are Mr. Smith?
Mr. Smith.
Mr. Smithson, then.
You better find another idiot, mate.
I don't know what else to say, sir.
Well, you don't know my name, and you think I'm going to tell you my bank details. You don't even know. If you're British Gas, how are you going to send me the money?
Well, basically, Cousin Benson, he has the rebate standing by.
Who's got the money standing by?
Cousin Benson.
Who?
My Cousin Benson.
Cousin Benson? What's that?
Sir, are you going to give me your bank account details or not?
Of course I'm not.
But I have a lot of other people to rebate
well,
today, sir.
Well, ring them then. Go on. I'm not interested in you. I don't know who you are.
I told you who I am, sir.
I don't know who you are. You're just talking a load of old nonsense.
Sir, I'm George Agdugdugwengo.
George? And you're talking about a cousin that deals with the money?
Money transfer, yeah. Cousin Benson.
How much is it?
The computer says that British Gas have overcharged you over the last 8 years. $36 million.
You better go off and try and find another idiot, mate, okay?
Besides, it's a lot of monies.
Goodbye.
Test. It's about my wife's bush. But sir, I am totally legitimate. Jude Law's testicles.
Hello?
Good morning, madam. I hope I have not interrupted your breakfast.
No. Who's speaking?
My name is George.
Yeah?
Basically, I'm calling from the Republic of Agdugdugwengo Prize-Giving Department.
Yeah?
I see from our database that you are owed a serious amount of monies.
How are you choosing the person?
Basically, what happens is, every month we have a series of delegates. These delegates each have a hat. Now, in the hat, there is a pot. In the pot, there are names. They pull the pot out of the hat. They pull a name out of the pot with the names of the hat in it. And basically, they put all of these names into another pot.
Mm.
Now, in the pot, the communal pot, they have another list of names. When they draw those names out of their hat, it all goes into another hat which contains a pot. And out of the pot, we drew your name.
Right.
So basically, all I require from you, madam,
yeah,
is your sort code and bank account number, and we can wire you the monies as soon as possible.
Yeah, but about how much are you speaking about it?
My computer says you have been designated £6.82, madam.
£6.82.
Yes.
Yeah, it's all right. I'm not in the same. The thing is, I don't like too much to give my bank account and my bank details in.
I totally understand that, madam, which is why we have a secure way of dealing with this problem. Basically, you give your details to me, I give them to nobody, and we wire you the monies directly.
Yeah, it's all right. It's all right. But I'm not interested anyway, okay?
Are you sure?
Sure.
Have a wonderful morning, madam.
You too. You too. Thank you very much.
Goodbye. Bye-bye.
Hello?
Good afternoon, sir. Basically, sir, I'm calling from your building society.
Mm-hmm.
It seems that there has been a slight discrepancy involving your bank account, sir.
Yeah?
Basically, what has happened is the monies that you have accumulated in your account over the years, sir.
Yeah?
They need to be pressed and steamed, you see.
Pressed and steamed?
Yeah. You know when you make a withdrawal at the cash points, huh?
Yeah.
The money comes out very crisp, yeah?
Oh, I see, yeah.
However, the man who was in charge of these responsibilities, he suffered a cardiac arrest, sir.
Oh, no.
Yes. And unfortunately, he has locked himself inside one of the vaults.
That's tough.
Now, inside one of these vaults, sir, is your bank account.
Mm.
But in order for us to get to him before he runs out of oxygen, we need to obtain your bank account details.
Yeah.
So that we can send the salvage team into the bank account, resuscitate the gentleman, send him to the ambulance, hospital, etc. And hopefully everything in the bank account should be as good as new.
Yeah, that would be great.
So if I could just take your sort code, sir.
But, yeah, unfortunately, I can't actually give you that on the phone, so I think we should leave him
but
there.
But, sir, the time is of the essence, sir.
Yeah, I'm sure.
The alarm bell went off less than 20 minutes ago.
Well, there we are.
It is my job to obtain as many personal details from you as possible.
Yeah, which which I'm afraid I'm not going to give to anyone I don't know, but it's...
But, sir, his life is on the line, sir.
I know. Well, poor chap, he's
going
to...
You're going to let him die in there.
I am, I'm...
But how are you going to get to your monies?
Well, I will,
The monies have not been pressed or steamed. If you go to the cash point, it will be unable to dispense monies to you.
Well, never mind. I'll have to find another one.
Sir, it is your conscience we are talking about here,
yeah,
sir.
I know.
Are you a Christian, sir?
I am, but anyway, thank you so much indeed.
Well, a good Christian would give me his sword code.
Yeah, well, I'm going to go now.
But, sir, it is totally innocent.
Hello?
Good evening, madam. I am calling from your bank.
I don't want anything from anybody.
What do you mean, sir? Why are you such a miser?
I don't want anything from anybody. I've got everything I want.
You've got everything you want?
Yeah.
What about £8 and 27 pence, sir?
I don't want £8 27 pence.
Why not?
Because I don't need it.
But you are a prize winner, sir.
I don't want to be a prize winner.
How does it feel?
I don't want to be a prize winner. I've got everything I want.
Well, I'm afraid you are a prize winner in the Republic of Agdugduguengo, sir.
But I don't want any prizes. You can keep your prizes.
I'm afraid I am not authorized to do that, sir. We must send you the cash prize immediately.
But I don't want it.
Where would you like me to wire you the money, sir?
I don't want it. I don't want any money wired to anywhere.
To your bank account, sir?
No, thank you.
Bank account details, sir. That's all I require.
No, I don't want anything off of anybody.
Why are you so miserable, sir?
I'm not miserable at all. I just don't need anything. I don't want anything.
But everybody could do with £8 and 23 pence.
So I've got £8 and 23 pence.
Well, you could double your money, sir.
Well, I don't want to. You have it.
I need some cheese.
Yeah?
Get a piece of cheddar, you cat.
Hello?
Hello?
Hello.
Good evening, sir. I'm calling from your credit card component.
I'm in bed.
I'm sorry?
I'm in bed.
Well, I cannot help that, sir. What has happened is we see in the database that the details of your credit card seem to be missing, sir.
Fuck off.
I beg your pardon?
Good evening, can I speak? How can I help you?
Hello, hi. My wife has left her mobile phone at home.
Yes?
And she's gone out for the night.
Yes?
I decided to have a look in her text messages.
Yes?
Meet you tonight at Zilly Fish, 8:30. I'll be wearing a straw hat. I'm worried that she's having an affair.
Just a second.
Have you seen a lady tonight wearing a straw hat?
Straw hat. Just a second, I'm going to look around for you, okay?
Thank you.
Gentlemen, hello.
Hello.
Hello, may I help you?
Yes. I've just explained to your waitress.
Yes, you're apparently looking for somebody.
No, my wife is having an affair.
It's not our problem, sir. I'm sorry.
Is she there?
I cannot keep you. I don't know who is your wife.
She's wearing a straw hat.
I don't know. There's no...
Can you just, for the sake of my marriage, just tell me whether there is a lady there, a large lady, wearing a straw hat? And if she is there, then is she with somebody? Come on, you're Italian.
Sir, look, there is a lady with a hat.
There is a lady with a hat.
If you want to... But I cannot keep it.
Is she on her own?
Is she with someone? Sorry?
Is she with someone?
With another person. I don't know who he is. It's not my problem.
Is she with another man?
No, it's not a man.
It's not a man?
It doesn't look like a man to me.
It's a woman.
Huh?
It's a woman.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Okay, so now I really have to go. Bye, sir. Bye-bye.
It is totally innocent.
Naked.
Hello, Big R.
Hello?
Hello.
Right, is that Big R?
Yeah, Big R.
Yeah, all right. I'm calling about the job you got going.
Okay, yeah, the canvas stretcher.
The canvas stretcher, yeah?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, I just wanted to, like, ask a few questions about it.
Yeah, sure.
How many days a week would I be required to, like, stretch a canvas?
I'm not sure. If you want to leave your details, then someone will get back to you.
My details?
Yeah.
All right. You got a pen?
Yep.
My name's Jafuli. I am so cool. I stretch a canvas. Cause I got the girth. Do I get a job? Do I get a job? Do I get a job? Do I?
Hello.
Hello. Yeah, sorry about that. I didn't mean to get off on the wrong foot and that. I didn't mean to, like, beatbox down the phone and that.
That's all right. I just...
People are like, well, you're not allowed to do that. And then I think, well, that's just, like, prejudice and that.
Yeah.
You know, but, I mean, look, I mean, you know, if you want my number, yeah, then I don't mind. But, like, I'm in a relationship at the moment, yeah, just to, like, be straight with you and that.
Well, I've got my boyfriend of 4 years standing in front of me as we speak.
Well, there you go then. That's the thing. It's like, you know, we need to, like, keep it incognito and that. But, you know, I'm willing to, like, meet up for, like, a preliminary drink and that. And then, you know, if I like what I see.
Put down the phone. Thank you.
Hey.
$86,000, madam.
That sounds lovely.
Grosvenor Shares, good afternoon.
Hello?
Hello, Grosvenor Shares.
Right. Apparently you guys do the best shirts in London, yeah?
Yeah.
Nice. The thing is, I got a date, yeah, on Saturday.
You got a date on Saturday?
Yeah. So I was looking for something a bit special, yeah? We're going to have some dinner, some dancing, that kind of thing.
Sounds wonderful.
So I thought maybe something a bit... You got anything like that?
Absolutely.
Yeah?
Yeah, you got some beautiful new stuff in.
All right. What's your price range for, like, one shirt?
One shirt, they range from about £75 to the top range is about £129.
It's a bit pricey, isn't it?
Yeah, well, they're beautiful shirts.
I know, but the thing is, I'm on a bit of a budget, yeah?
All right.
You got anything a bit...
No.
Good afternoon, Flower Central.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi there. I bought a piece of art from you.
Mm-hmm.
About a week ago.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the thing. I mean, we tried to decipher the signature at the bottom, but it just looks like a squiggle.
What's your name?
Brian.
Your surname?
Bodondi.
Could you spell that, please?
Yes. It's B.
B.
Burr.
Sorry, could you say B?
Burr.
O.
Burr.
Uh-huh.
Ba. Burr. But de bum burr.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch that.
Sorry. Burr. But de burr. Burr. Excuse me, I'm terribly sorry. I don't think I've taken my British passion. But the piece of art actually burnt.
I think we're probably having a problem with the telephone line. I can't hear you very well.
Sorry? Hello?
Hello?
But the piece of art burnt.
No, I'm afraid I can't tell you unless you tell me your name or the name
of
the work.
But I'm Brian.
Yeah?
But the bong bong.
Could you spell that for me?
Burr. 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 Burr.
No, I'm sorry.
But the bong bong. Burr.
Did you buy it from Flowers East?
Burr.
Hello?
Yeah, good evening. How can I help you?
Is that the front desk?
Yes, sir.
Hello, yes. This is Donald Donaldson. I'm staying in room 513.
Mm-hmm.
Who's this?
My name is sir.
How old are you?
I'm sorry?
How old are you?
Well, I wouldn't tell you my age, sir.
Do you consider yourself attractive, yes or no?
Well, I don't know, sir. What do you want me to do for you, sir?
I'd like you to pour bubble bath into my hot bath. Then I'd like you to take off your belt and whip me. Would you do that?
No, sir. I wouldn't do that.
Why not?
Why?
Yes. I'm a guest at your hotel, am I not?
No, sir. I would never do that, sir.
But please, I want you to.
Well, sir,
if you don't come up here and spank me immediately, I'm going to come down there and spank you.
Spank me?
Yes.
Why?
Because you deserve it.
I deserve it?
Yes, and you'd like it too, wouldn't you?
I'm sorry, sir. I need to leave right now.
Sir, I need to see your uniform.
Why you have to see
I want
right
to wear
now?
Your shoes. On my hands. And I'm going to do a handstand for you. Naked.
I'm sorry, sir. I need to leave right now, sir. I don't want to hear about it.
I bet you do, darling.
Thank you, bye.
Good evening, madam. I am calling from your bank. But before we continue, I'm afraid I have to ask you a number of security questions in order for you to confirm that
right.
It is in fact you are speaking with to me. Are we ready?
Yeah.
Good. What is the day?
What's the day?
Yes.
So Tuesday, Monday.
I'm afraid I'm going to have to accept your first answer, madam, which was Thursday, which is wrong. I'm afraid I have to terminate this call.
It is totally innocent.
Naked.
Hi.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm calling from the money transfer.
From the what?
The Eastern Union money transfer.
Eastern European money transfer?
Yes. It says here on the computer that you have 86,000 Ugandan dollars waiting to be paid directly into your bank account.
Oh, yeah.
It seems that you have answered all the security questions correctly, but you're having a little trouble gaining access to it.
To what?
To your bank account.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. I just need to obtain your sort code and account number, and we can...
You're having a fucking laugh.
I beg your pardon?
You're calling me up, making out that I'm worth some money, and you want my bank details. Are you kidding?
Nobody has...
Are you kidding?
There is no prize draw here,
what
sir.
What the hell are you talking about? Who are you?
Somebody has paid their monies into your bank account, sir.
Somebody has paid 86 what?
1,000 Ugandan dollars.
Well, what is that in sterling?
At the current exchange rate, the Ugandan monies would translate into approximately £17.52.
£17.52, and you want my sort code?
An account number, sir.
You've got no chance.
But, sir, we have 86,000 Ugandan dollars standing by waiting to be paid directly into your bank account.
I don't care. I don't even know who you are.
Well, basically, sir, if we do not pay the monies into your bank account, then we have to charge you storage because we have to keep the monies here.
You have to charge me storage? What are you on about?
Sir, we need your bank account details.
You need my bank account details?
Yes.
How's about this? Fuck off.
Is that the sort code, sir?
Hello?
Good afternoon, madam. I am calling from your building society. But basically, before we continue, I need to ask you a series of security questions in order for me to confirm that it is actually me you are speaking to.
Yeah.
What is your name?
My name?
Correct. What is your favorite color?
I don't know who I'm talking to, but...
Correct. What is your sort code?
My what?
Your sort code?
86,000 Ugandan dollars, madam.
That sounds lovely.
Hello?
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 Good morning, sir. Sorry to trouble you. I'm calling from your bank. Now, sir...
Sorry, where is this, sorry?
I'm sorry?
Sorry, who are you and what are you ringing about?
I'm calling from your bank, sir.
My bank?
Yes. Basically, we have discovered a pigeon inside the bank vault, sir. Now, as you
pigeon?
Know, sir... Yes, a pigeon. You know what a pigeon is, sir?
A pigeon?
Yes.
It's a bird.
Yes, there is a pigeon inside your bank account, sir. We need to remove it as soon as possible.
Pigeon inside my bank account?
Yes, a pigeon that has been spending a lot of time in the air conditioning unit. Now, as you know, sir, when you spend a lot of time underneath an air conditioner, you potentially catch a cold. So basically, there is a pigeon who potentially has bird flu inside the bank vault of the bank. So what we need, sir, is your account number so that we can enter your bank account, send the decontamination unit inside, remove the monies, decontaminate, remove the pigeon, and then return the monies once the decontamination has concluded.
Oh, right, I see, yes, I understand now, yes.
Excellent. So if I could just start with the account number, sir.
Yeah, sure, just bear with me a moment. It's 289-28771.
Okay, now on the bank account, would there be any security questions, a mother's maiden name, favorite color, favorite flavor of ice cream perhaps, that you may have placed on the account to deter...
Yeah, you're a security name, dear.
Do you have a security question on your bank account, sir?
Yeah, it's Jimmy Savile.
What is the question, though?
Who's your uncle? That's the question. Who is your uncle? And the answer is Jimmy Savile.
Your uncle is Jimmy Savile.
It is. I don't know if you know him. Have you heard of him?
I do know Jimmy Savile, sir.
You know him?
Yeah.
My world.
I'm a big fan of Jimmy Savile.
Oh, right.
I Gmailed a fixer for you.
Oh, fantastic.
I sent him many letters as a child, sir.
Oh, right. Excellent.
He didn't send me back a thing.
What's your name? Sorry.
All I really wanted was the medal, you know, the gold medal on the red ribbon. But luckily, my father, he make me one anyway.
Right. Well, yeah, we could get the pigeon out for me. That'd be fantastic. Thank you.
But yes, no, the pigeon must be removed as soon as possible. Because it potentially carries the bad flu virus strain.
It does. I don't want that flu. Yeah, we could get it out of my bank account for me. That'd be excellent. Excellent. Thanks very much indeed for that.
No problem at all,
sir.
Thank
you. Bye. Hello.
Hello, madam. Could I ask you a series of security questions enabling me to enter your bank account?
No, certainly not.
Excellent. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello?
Hello?
Hello.
Good day, sir. This is George. I'm calling from your bank.
From my bank?
Yes. The reason I'm calling you, sir, is because on Monday, at about midnight, the man who was in charge of refilling the cash point at the bank, he discovered an illegal card reader inside one of the cash points.
Mm-hmm.
So I just need your sort code and account number so that we can compare them with the details that he had when he was in there.
Who are you calling from?
I'm calling from the bank.
Which bank?
Your bank.
Which is my bank?
The bank that you bank with.
Yeah, and what's that called?
It's one of the major banks, sir.
No, I suggest you hang up and run because I'm going to phone the police.
But why would you want to do that, sir? I'm totally legitimate.
Listen, if you think for one minute you're absolute bloody buffoon, I'm going to give you my bank details over the phone.
Sir, please, I do not appreciate this language you're using against me, sir.
I've never used language.
You called me a buffoon.
Yeah, well, that's not swearing.
No, but you are assuming I'm homosexual, sir. I do not appreciate that.
Yeah, but Mr. Buffoon, you don't even know what bank I'm banking.
Please refrain from calling me a buffoon again, sir.
Not a buffoon. It's an animal, you idiot.
Then you're calling me an idiot, sir. Why are you trying to abuse me, sir? I'm just trying to do my job.
You're not. You have to identify yourself. Who are you?
I have identified myself. My name is George Agdugudugwengo.
George, what's your surname? How do you spell that?
Agdugudugwengo.
Can you spell that for me?
Sir, time is of the essence, sir. We can only hold the illegal card reader in custody for another 48 hours.
What, a card reader is an item that they stick to the machine. You talking about the person you've arrested?
No, sir, the person I've arrested is the illegal card reader. He was placed inside the cash point.
The illegal card reader was placed in a cash line machine?
Yes.
And you have now got that?
I have him. He was found at midnight on Monday. He had been in there for quite a while.
Right.
Apparently, the smell was not something too pleasant.
Well, I'm not giving you any details. You can't even tell me what my name is.
I do know your name, sir.
What's my name?
You are Mr. McDougall?
No. Try again.
But you sound like Mr. McDougall to me.
McDougal before, have you?
Yes, he was a performer.
Deutsche Inquiries, how may I help you?
Hello, yes. Could I have DIFFS in London, please?
I'm sorry, can you have which number in London?
DIFFS.
Right, how are you spelling the name, please?
It's D-F-S.
D-F-S?
DIFFS.
Right, no, sir, can you confirm which name you require?
Yes, DIFFS.
Right, and you're spelling it. How are you spelling it then, sir?
I spelled for you already.
I didn't hear you, sir. This is why I'm asking you to repeat.
Well, I spelled for you again. It's D-F-S.
If it's D-F-S, is it a furniture store?
Yes, they sell test for three-piece suite.
Right, sir, so it's D-F-S, not DIFFS?
DIFFS.
No, it's just known as D-F-S, sir.
D-F-S.
No, sir. D-F-S.
D-F-S.
No, sir. Can you just forget everything we've said? The letters, D-F-S, is just the name. There is no pronunciation of it.
The fifth is it.
Thank you.
Good morning, KL Electronics.
Hello?
Hello, can I help you?
Hello, yes. I wanted to check some prices for your Vusre player.
For what, sorry?
A Vusre.
Vusre?
Yes.
What's a Vusre?
It plays verse.
Sorry?
It plays verse.
Plays what?
You know the verse cassette tape.
Oh, VHS.
Verse, yes.
What is the problem then?
But I want to buy a Vusre.
We don't sell videos.
You don't sell the verse?
We don't sell videos.
What do you sell?
We don't sell.
You don't sell?
We repair videos.
Oh, you do repair verse?
Videos?
Yes, verse. Because I wanted to buy a new Vusre.
I've no idea what you're saying.
The Vusre.
I have no idea what you're saying.
I had the Vusre and it broke. So I call up all these places. I say, I want to buy verse. They say, we don't sell the verse. Everything is duped.
You know, this Vusre, I've never heard of this before in my life, quite honestly.
A Vusre player, it plays verse.
Yeah, look, we're going nowhere. If you bring your video in, we'll have a look at it for you.
I bring in the Vusre.
Okay.
You want to buy verse tape?
No, I don't want to buy enough.
You don't own a Vusre.
Hello?
Hello, yes. Could you check something for me to see if it's in stock?
What is it, sir?
It's a Lutsch Duft player.
Sorry?
Duft player.
What is that, sorry?
It plays Dufte.
Plays what?
Dufte.
Dufte?
Yes.
I'm sorry, I don't understand what you heard.
You know Duft?
No, I don't.
You know he used to have the Betamax, and
oh,
then
yeah.
It changed to the Verse?
You have VHS?
Yes.
You want a VHS player?
No, I don't want Verse. I want Duft.
By Duft?
Duft.
Okay, I have no idea what Duft is.
Duft, Duft. You want me to spell?
Yes.
Is it D?
Yeah.
V?
Oh, DVD.
Duvde.
DVD.
Duvde.
Hold on. I don't know anything about Duft player. Okay, all I know is DVD player.
Duvde, yes.
They start from £60 upwards.
£60 for one Duvke?
Yes.
How much you sell me Lukatov?
Which one?
Lukatov.
What is that?
I used to have the plasma turf, and now I wanted to buy the Lukatov.
Are you trying to say LCD?
Lukatov, yes.
No, don't... Hey, look at it. I don't know what... It's LCD.
Yes, look at it.
No, we have LCD.
Well, what make you have in the look at it?
What make do you want in a look at it?
A Juvk.
Sorry?
A Juvk look at it.
Yes, we have JVC. Is that what you're trying to say?
Juvke.
No, JVC.
Juvke.
Look, JVC.
No, Juvke.
I don't have any jerk.
No, Juvke
look at it. We don't have such a make as jerk.
Not jerk. I don't say jerk. I say
no,
Juvke.
I'm saying jerk because, you know, I don't understand. If you're saying JVC... Then say JVC.
Juvke.
No, there's no Juvke. It's JVC. If that's what you want, then let's talk.
You have the Juvke.
No, I don't have Juvke. And, you know,
what is Juvke then?
If you're going, look, you know, what am I supposed to tell you?
What is your problem?
I don't have any problem. The problem
first
is with
you. First you tell me you don't sell Duvde, and then you tell me you do sell the Duvde.
Listen, I don't have
Juvke. Then you tell me you don't sell look
listen,
at the
Duvde. Jerk. I said, we don't have jerks.
I don't want the jerk.
I want
the Juvke.
So, if you want, you know...
I want Juvke.
Say what you want exactly. I don't understand what you're trying to tell
me. Okay, I tell you from the beginning, okay? I want one Juvke Duvde player.
I don't know what
and
you
I
mean
want
by
one
No, excuse me.
Juvke
Lukatov. Listen, I don't know what you're trying to tell me.
With the hood.
I don't know anything about
ready
Jupiter.
For the
I don't
hood.
Know anything about
ready for the hood. Is it ready for the hood?
Sorry?
Is it ready for the hood?
It's ready for what?
The hood, you know? Hood.
Waiter!
John Thornton's bookshop.
Hello there, is that the bookshop?
Yes, I do.
Oh, lovely. It's Tarquin here. I'm calling from BT Telephone Engineer.
Right.
Just checking your line to see whether you got a bit of a crackle. Oh, sounds like you do have a bit of a crackle. Can you do me a favour? Are you on a headset or a handset?
No, a regular, you know, landline. But
I'm afraid you're going to have to be a bit more specific.
Well, there's a phone sitting on the desk here.
Right, so it's a landline.
Yeah.
Right. And how many holes are actually in the mouth? You know the mouthpiece that you speak into?
Yeah.
Yeah. How many holes are in there, please?
One.
Just one. And yeah. On the bit that you hear my voice coming out of, how many holes are in that?
Six.
Six.
Yeah.
Right.
And but I haven't heard this crackling until... I mean, this is the first time I've heard this on the phone call that you're making. We've used this phone all day long. I don't hear these crackles.
Can you hear a crackle?
Yeah, but this is the first time I've heard this, and, you know...
It sounds pretty clear from my end. Are you sure you can hear a crackle?
Yeah, I hear a crackle.
Oh, you do hear a crackle?
Yeah, but what
right.
I'm trying to...
Because basically what they're laying some pipes in the area, you see. Because there's an oil thing going on. I'm not sure what it. I think it's got something to do with the pigeons. But if you could just do me a favor, could you just give your handset a little tap?
What is the purpose of the phone call?
Well, to try and fix the crackle.
But there wasn't a crackle.
Well, you just told me there is a crackle.
Only since you've rung.
Well, yes. Well, how was I supposed to know there's a crackle? I only know what you tell me, dear. Can you do me a favor? Can you just tap the handset very lightly and tell me if the crackle goes?
No.
Is it gone?
No.
It's still there. Could you just tap it a little harder, please?
No.
Did you tap it?
Sorry?
Give it a good bang, girl. Don't be shy.
I still hear the crackle.
You still hear the crackle?
Yeah.
Oh, dear. I might have to do a little vocal test. Could you just give me an R, please?
I'm sorry. I've got customers here.
Could you just give me a sustained R?
Hello,
mate. It's Steve.
Beef?
Steve with the Bit Bobs.
I think you got the wrong number, mate. I don't know who you are.
Well, Ali, you said it hats. Hats and the gloves.
Yeah.
And the underpants.
Yeah.
Mike on the crepes, right?
Told okay.
Steve on a fish. The Russ on the fruit and veg.
Yeah.
Told Angela about the tinsel, right? But the thing was, that was last week. So I'm reckoning we go halves. What do you reckon? On a bit, Bobs. Did no one mention the Jing Jangs here?
I'm still lost, you know, I can't remember who
the
we
Jing Jangs and the Flybernights. Come on, mate, you must remember. We spoke about it last week.
Are you the wholesaler or what?
No, I'm on the no. The Nanas.
Banana?
Yeah, the bananas, you know, the silver bowls. £2 a pop for you. I'll tell you what. £2 a pop, I'll give you a free apple. You go away and think about it, all right?
All
right. Cheers.
I need some cheese.
Yeah?
Give me a piece of cheddar, you cat.
Renta.
Hello?
Renta.
Hi, is that Cafe Italia?
Italia Uno, yeah.
Buongiorno.
Buongiorno,
buonasera. Grazie.
Prego.
I've arranged to meet somebody.
Yeah.
At the cafe.
Yeah.
But I'm running a little bit late.
Yeah, okay, what time?
Well, I believe the gentleman's waiting for me.
Yeah, what's his name?
It's Luke.
Sorry?
Luke.
Luke?
But no, wait, don't tell him that you're talking to me.
Ah, I see.
Because it's a blind date, you see.
Yeah.
I just wanted to know...
Yeah?
...what he looked like.
Ah, I see. There's one guy, I don't know, I think it's him, probably.
Right.
He's quite fat, yeah?
He's what?
Short and fat. How old is he?
Short and fat?
Yeah,
fucking
yeah.
Hell.
Yes, the only person that he's well built, and...
No, you just said fat. Now you're lying to me.
Yes, yeah.
Don't lie to me, Giuseppe.
Yeah, that's the only one I know, yeah?
Right.
Yeah, just ordered a Diet Coke. I don't know.
Well, it's a bit late for that, isn't it?
Yeah.
So, do you think it's worth a squeeze?
I don't know.
Would you give him one?
No.
You wouldn't?
No.
You prefer someone a bit slimmer?
Yeah.
Like me?
Yeah, I don't know who you are. Okay.
What if I laid you on a ciabatta and covered you in mozzarella?
No. Okay, see you later. Okay, bye.
Okay, bye.
It is totally innocent. Naked.
Good evening, Shazir Ashala Street, Joseph speaking.
Hello?
Hello.
Hello. Would I book a table, please?
Sorry, sir?
Would I book a table?
For sure. For what time are you looking for?
8 o'clock.
8 o'clock. Boo. For how many people, sir?
Boo.
Two?
Boo, people. Yes.
Two people, yes?
Boo.
8 o'clock.
By the window.
By the window. It's fine, sir.
Yes?
Yeah.
Okay,
can I have your name, please?
Udi Bung Bung.
Udi Bung Bung.
Yes. I'll be you at 8. Okay?
Okay, bye.
Okay, bye.
Hello? Hello, yes.
Is that the fishmonger?
That is, yes.
Yeah, I bought the fresh fish from you?
Yes.
And I take it home to my wife?
All right, yep.
And she says it's a goldfish?
Sorry?
She told me it's a goldfish.
I don't understand you.
I came to your market, yeah?
Yeah.
You sell the fresh fish?
Yeah.
I buy the fresh fish from you?
Right.
But then I take it home, I take it to my wife?
Right.
My wife, she a fish cook?
Oh, right.
But she tell me it's a goldfish?
A fresh fish or a smoked fish?
It's just fresh fish. It's not a smoked fish. It's a goldfish. You know, you put in the bowl, you feed it.
And what kind of fish you want?
I don't want a goldfish.
Goldfish?
Yep.
No, I haven't sold you goldfish. I don't sell goldfish.
Well, I'm coming by and bring the goldfish. You're going to change it to the fresh fish.
You bring back whatever you bought off of me and I'll have a look at it.
And I'm going down, Mr. Drew, and I have a Akia saltfish.
Sorry?
86,000 Ugandan dollars, madam.
That sounds lovely.
Good evening, Mackenzie. How can I help you?
Hello.
Hiya.
Hi there. It's Donald. I work on the third floor. How are you?
Yeah, I'm fine, thank you.
How's the front desk? Is everything in order?
Everything is in order, yeah.
Wonderful. Who's that?
It's Richard.
Hello, Richard. What time are you working until?
Starting from 7 to 7 in the morning.
My God. 7 till 7?
That's 12-hour shift.
So what are you doing between, say, 1 a.m. and 3?
1 a.m. and 3?
Yes.
The thing is,
I've just had an executive bathroom put into my office.
Okay.
And I'm having a bit of trouble running the bath in there. So, how's about you come up at, say, 1:30?
1:30?
Yeah.
To where, please?
To my office. I've got some champagne and, nibbles. Maybe we could, have a drink, have a chat and fuck like rabbits. What do you say?
Yeah, sorry, you're not allowed to drink whilst on duty.
Do you like baby oil?
No.
Well, I do.
Oh.
Tell me, are your hands rough or smooth?
Smooth.
They're very smooth.
Yeah.
Well, we need to rough them up a bit. How does that sound?
Yeah, who wants to speak into, please?
Donald.
Donald.
Call me Johnny.
Okay.
Listen, I'm making an omelette. What would you like me to put in it? Apart from my cock.
No, how can I love my fellow man?
Have you ever tried? I bet you're wearing a G-string under that uniform, aren't you?
No.
Yes, your wife's G-string, secretly, when she goes out.
No, I don't.
You do?
I don't worry, man.
I've had enough of your lies. I'm going.
All right.
Good night.
Good morning, next to me, Portsmouth. How may I help?
Hello.
Hello there.
Hello. Birbal Bungalows.
Sorry?
Birbal Bungalows.
You'd like to buy a bungalow?
Bur.
Pardon?
Bur.
Sorry?
Bungalow.
Bungalow.
Bur. Birbal them?
Pardon?
Birbal Bungalows.
Do I want to buy a bungalow?
Bur. Birbal Bungalows.
You'd like to buy a bungalow?
Bur.
Yes?
Bur.
No.
Bur.
Pardon?
Birbal Bungalows. Bur.
Hello?
Bur.
Yeah, we have no bungalows.
Birbal Bungalows, Bur.
Sorry, we have no bungalows.
Bur Bungalows. Bur.
Which name, please?
Hello?
Hello, can I help you?
Hello, yes. Could I have Duvla in Swansea, please?
Sorry, what was the name?
Duvla.
Can you spell it for me, please?
Yes. Is it D?
D, yes.
V?
V for Victor.
L?
The D-V-L-A.
Duvla.
No, it's not pronounced Duvla, it's pronounced D-V-L-A.
Duvlila.
No, D-V-L-A it is.
Duvla.
Shall I put you through?
What, to the Duvla?
No, through to the D-V-L-A.
No, I need the number for the Duvla.
Thank you.
Can we help you?
Hello?
Hello, how can I help?
Hello, yes. Could I have Duhl in London, please?
What's all in London?
Duhl.
Are you spelling that, please?
Is it D?
D for Delta.
H?
H Hotel.
L?
L DHL in London.
Duhl.
Are they a courier company?
Yes, Duhl.
Right, I got DHL Express Customer Service.
DHL.
Or there's DHL Same Day.
DHL.
Yeah, they're both under DHL.
But I need Duhl.
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 What sort of business is Duhl, please?
They send a package.
I'll just transfer you to supervisor. It won't be a moment.
Thank you.
Thank you for calling Games. This is Tyson speaking. How can I help you?
Hello?
Yes.
Hello, yes. You sell the Puss 3?
What?
You sell the Puss 3?
Oh, yes, we do.
You do sell the Puss 3?
Yes.
How much for one Puss 3?
$599.99.
That's quite pricey for the Puss. How much for one Puss 2?
Oh, PS2?
Yes, Puss 2.
$119 if you get the Slim.
The Slim Puss?
Uh-huh.
You play with the Slim Puss?
No, I have a PS3 and a 360. And a Nintendo Wii.
What about the DS?
I don't have one.
You don't have a DS?
No.
Because you're too busy playing with the Wii?
I don't, exactly.
I think you need to play more with the Puss.
Well, not really, not much. I'll probably play for like maybe 10 minutes and...
10 minutes on the Puss?
Uh-huh.
How are you ever going to find a girlfriend if you're going to only play on the Puss for 10 minutes?
Oh, I mean, I just keep it just to have it. I don't actually care that, like, you know...
Oh, you just like to own the Puss.
I don't really care if I own it. Like, I don't even really want it. It's just, I just have it just to have it.
Oh, just to have the Puss.
Mm-hmm.
You're a player, huh?
I don't play it much. Like, I hardly ever play it.
I know, but when you own the Puss, you need to take care of the Puss.
Uh-huh.
Which means you have to play on the Puss every night. Because if you don't play on the Puss, then you're going to lose the Puss. You know?
You don't have to. It's just, it's easy for me not to play it.
Because you're too busy playing with your Duss.
Sir, I have customers in front of me, so is there any other way I can help you?
I think I'm just going to go and buy a perk.
Hello, Vlad speaking. How can I help?
Hello, yes. I wanted to check some prices for your perk.
Which one are you looking for, sir?
Which make you have of the perk?
We have IBM's, Acer, Asus, Sony.
Do you have Herp?
What? Sorry?
Herb.
Hub.
Herb.
What is that, sir? I'm sorry, can you spell that for me?
Yes. It's a hedge?
Yes.
P.
Okay, Hewlett Packard.
Herb, yes.
Yeah, it's not called Herb, sir. It's called HP or Hewlett Packard.
Herb.
Okay, thank you.
How much for one herb perk?
What sort of work do you want to do with it, sir?
Well, I was thinking some word processing.
Okay.
Surfing the woo.
Okay.
And burning doof.
Okay. Yeah, all of them will do that.
How many USB does it have?
How many what?
USB.
Hold on a second, sir.
Okay, so we established this is HP.
Yes, a herb laptop.
Yeah.
And it come with three USB.
Three boost, yeah.
No, USB.
What?
Three USB.
That's three. That's called USB.
USB.
No, USB.
USB.
No, it's not called USB. It's called USB.
USB.
No, it's called USB.
USB.
No, USB.
USB.
Not USB, no.
USB.
Look, the whole world knows this as USB.
No, the whole world knows it as USB.
Okay, whatever.
Good.
Thank you for calling.